Hello everyone, FunctionX here. Welcome back to Feed the Beast Beyond Mods A to Z, where we're going to cover every single mod in the Feed the Beast pack, and so you will be an expert. Today we are covering a mod called Woot. We're going to the end of the alphabet for this one, guys. This is the Woot mod, and it's basically a mod that allows you to create really awesome mob farms. You're saying, well, I can create a mob farm without a mod. Why do I need this? Well, the cool thing about Woot is you're not actually spawning any mobs or killing them. It's all done inside magical blocks. So that means, you know, less lag all around. Less server lag, client lag, video lag, frame rates, everything is going to be improved by using these mob spawners over a regular mob spawner. Now, what's the cost? Well, cost is a lot of crafting. You're going to be doing crafting like crazy to get this mod up and running, and you're going to have to be giving it a lot of power. So if you have auto crafting and power, then you're golden, really. And they're going to have to kind of find mobs in order to be able to spawn them. But the rewards for this work, guys, are through the roof. This thing is borderline. No, it is overpowered. It's very overpowered once you get enough power, which is kind of interesting. Let's get right into it. How do we start off? Well, here's all the items pretty much from the mod. Very simple amount of items here. If you want the book, it says work in progress. It's got a few errors in it. It's not fancy or anything, but it does, you know, do pretty well. It's just got a bunch of pages you can cycle through if you want to. It's a normal book and a head, so might as well get one just in case you have questions about it. But really, you want to start out by getting the Yah Hammer, yet another hammer. And that one's nether brick, so you have to visit the nether to start this mod. Sticks, string, got it. Then you're going to build all these casing dies. Now these are dies as in die casts, not dies as in colorful dies. There's actually a typo in the Woot manual where he refers to them as dies, like D-Y-E, but it's fixed up here. So you're going to make one of each of these dies. Now to do that, you're going to take some obsidian, some gold and iron bars, and then different items in the middle to make these. And yeah, you're going to want to make one of each of them. There are seven, but you'll need all of them. And the cool thing is they're never used up. You never lose them. So as long as you have the hammer and the dies, you can make pretty much anything from the mod, given the proper materials. So you're going to have everything like that. Now, the next thing is to go out and capture the mob that you want to spawn. And you do that inside a mob prism. So you're going to take that mob prism in your hotbar. You're going to go find a mob. Let's just get a pig. For some reason, we want to kill pigs for some food. So we'll put that guy down. And we're just going to punch him with the prism. So left click. And you can see it says mob pig programmed. All right, let me get a sword to kill this pig. Here, piggy, piggy, piggy. He's a little too loud. But you only have to punch him once. I've never seen it fail as far as, you know, having to punch him multiple times. But you can see you can do pretty much every mob here. And we'll talk about these later. But right now we have a pig, essence, or something trapped in this prism. It says it's tier 1. Now that's important because we're going to start out with a tier 1 and move our way up through tier 2, tier 3, tier 4. And a lot of people I see play Feed the Beast Beyond, they want to go right to a tier 4, and then they complain about how long it takes to craft it. Well, that's not the point of the mod. The mod is to start out at tier 1, work your way up, spread it out over a long period of time. If you want to just go right to tier 4 for the Ender Dragon spawner, it's going to take you a while. It's going to cause, you know, you're going to get burned out just crafting stuff. So, yeah, find something out of the tier 1 list that you want to craft, and then while that's generating for you, then build up to tier 2, get some tier 2 mob, and then build up over time, right? Alright, so we've got that. Now we want to build one of these mob factory layout blocks that helps us lay out these little temple altar looking things. And it's pretty easy. It's this factory casing with a stone block. The factory casing is that casing die. We made the die, right? With some under iron plates and a hammer. And remember I told you the hammer and the die are not used up. The other five items are. So, but you're going to get four casings out of it. The under iron plates are crafted this way. Under iron with a plate die and a cobblestone. And again, hammer, die, not consumed. And that gets you four for one iron. How the heck do we get the iron? We need this pulverized iron, which needs iron, nether brick, and cobblestone for two of them. So you can see I've got that here. And you can see if as I craft one, the hammer and the die will not be consumed, but the other ingredients are. All right. This used to be obsidian down here. That's changed recently. Used to like have an obsidian piece here that would never be consumed, but now it's cobble and it is consumed. So that answers the question there. So we showed, I think we know how to get all these items now. Yeah, so we get the factory casing, we get the factory layout block. I forgot to show you how to craft the prism. The prism, you need the prism frame, which is eye of ender, under iron, cobblestone, prism die hammer. Like this guy. No, this guy. There we go. Get the prism frame. That'll craft one for you. And then you're going to put that, surround it with the colors of the rainbow. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue. There's no indigo, but we get the violet or purple. And some other under iron armor. And you're going to get one prism per prism frame. So you can see that's consumed. So everything in this recipe is consumed. But you're going to want to probably craft a few of these so you can different mob types, right? Right now we can only get pig. All right, and then the last one, you're going to need a bunch of these connector blocks. We'll see that in a minute. But we're just going to go put this mob factory layout block down in the ground. Now, this is different from a previous version of the mod. You needed to put it one space above the ground. Now you put it actually in the ground, and it'll be one level up higher than you put the block where this temple will sit. So you could, you know, build it down in and sink this down a little bit more if you want to, but let's just leave it up like this. So now this kind of gives you a little diagram of what you need to build to make the tier 1 altar. Now if you want to go right to a tier 2, tier 3, tier 4, you just right click on that block and you can see it expands the design out to whatever tier you're building. Let's just start with tier 1. You can see this one is made up of gray blocks, red blocks, a white looking creeper face, the mob controller itself, and then the mob spawner. Alright, so let's look at how to make all those. Here's the gray block. That is made with a bone and a factory casing. Remember, we got four factory casings for this recipe here. So you're gonna be crafting a lot, right? Because we need, I think, 13 of these gray blocks. And then the red blocks are the same casing with rotten flesh. So with bones and flesh, zombies and skeletons, you can get pretty much this mob thing set up. So let's go ahead and get those and just place them down, right? Like it says, they're kind of, the red and gray are in a checkerboard pattern. And they're going to be the same pattern for tier 2, tier 3, and tier 4. Like if I just click on this, you can see they're in the same location. So that's why you can build the tier 1 and then upgrade it to tier 2 through tier 4. Because you're not going to have to tear anything down. You just kind of add more around the perimeter. All right, so let's put the red ones in here. One red up there. Okay, and then a gray one there. And we're pretty much done with the red and gray. Now these white little skeletons up here are the tier 1 capstone. Now these are things that do change between the tiers. As you see, that's a tier 2. It has the yellow capstone. And the white capstones are actually replaced with a red block. So be careful when you're upgrading that you actually replace the capstones. All the way up to tier 4 where they're the emerald ones. But the iron ones, you need stone, the factory cap, glowstone, and a plated skull, which is any kind of heads on a skull die with iron and cobblestone. You get two of those for that. So we're going to get these caps. Put those on there and there. Okay. And then we're going to need the controller, or the factory block itself. And that is crafted with these connectors, which I showed you before. Redstone block, lapis block, nether quartz, and cobble to get you 9 of them. And then what was the other components? A factory casing, which we've shown, and then a tier 1, tier 2, and tier 3. These are all crafted the same way. Under iron in the bottom, casing in the middle with shards. So you've got either quartz shards, emerald shards, diamond shards. And the shards are all crafted. I need to go back there. There we go. With the shard die, and then the ingredient in cobble. So that's quartz shards. That's emerald shards, and that's diamond shards. So it's not really expensive. You're just using one diamond, really. One emerald and one nether quartz to get those. So there's this, and you'll never need to craft another one of these again. So that's easy, unless you're making multiple altars. All right, so there, and then the last one is our actual mob controller. And this controls what mob this thing will spawn. So we put that on top, and if we right-click on it, it should multi-block. And if it doesn't, it's going to tell us what's wrong. And this is saying unprogrammed mob controller. If we were missing a block and we clicked it, it would say, I don't know. I thought it would tell us there was a block in the wrong place, but maybe not. What if we put a green? Yeah, oh well. There we go. So we'll put that on there, and then we need to control which mob spawns, and that we do by using the mob prism. Right click on there. We're going to keep this thing, so we can always have this prism pig if we want to use it another time. And this mob controller, if you look at Wayla there, is now a pig type, and it says requires tier 1, which matches what was on our prism. And if we highlight over the factory block now, it will show you a few things. First, how much RF is stored internally. These things can store tons of RF, like millions. the state is on. We could have a lever here to turn this on and off. Might as well. All right, so now it's off, so it won't be spawning anything. So that's nice to know, so you can control whether it spawns or not. The little thing by the compass is progress. That's like once it gets to 100, it will generate, it will kill a mob. It'll kill a pig, right? It'll spawn a pig. It tells us one pig every 320 ticks, which is about 16 seconds. And it costs 96 RF a tick to run at optimal speed. If you give it less, you'll still get pigs. You're just going to get them less often. If we sneak, hit shift, it's going to tell us what we're going to get for killing the pig. We have 100% chance of getting pork, basically, is what that's saying. All right. So that is our tier 1 altar. Now, how do we give power to this thing? For that, we actually have to go underneath it. There's no way to give power to the top. You can delete this mob factory block. Well, don't delete it, but you can get rid of it if you want. And then you can see here is the power input right here. So let's just get a creative capacitor bank. And let's get some conduit just so I can show a few things. All right, so I'm going to put this actually right here. Conduit, and now it's getting power. And you can see the progress is moving up. So every 16 seconds, we should get some pork. Let's just go ahead and see. Wait, where is it going to put the pork? Oh, I don't know. Well, it's going to output it out of the factory block, so we need to have a chest somewhere near this factory block. All right, so let's put that right there. Now it should output our pork into this chest when it reaches 100%, which it just did. And there's the pork. We got two pork, actually. Sweet. Cool. And it's going to almost get up to 100% again. And that's it, guys. Give it power, it produces whatever, it kills whatever mob you program it to kill. And we're getting two pork per kill. Sweet. Now, what if you don't want to put this chest up here? Because it kind of looks, I don't know, it gets in the way of the mod. The mod looks really cool without these diamond chests hanging out in front. Well, there is a way to fix that. You can take these conduits out here and grab these blocks called the factory extender and factory proxy. Those are crafted with repeaters and casings, and then a repeater casing and a hopper. And you're gonna wanna take this extender and put it there, and you can actually use this extender, you know, a few blocks down if you really want to. I don't, I think right, well, let's do one more. And let's put the proxy right there. And you can see that multi-blocks as long as you built that right. And now that gives us four locations all around here where we can both provide power and accept output. So I can put my chest here and my capacitor bank there. And now it's providing power to this thing. And we should be getting our pork chop in that basket once we get rid of this one. Oops. So we'll see if it gets back up to 100 just to verify this is working. Come on. All right, should have got some output. There we go. We got three pork that time. Sweet. So that's how you do it if you want to, you know, we could pipe it into an AE system or something else, provide power through flux networks, whatever you want to do. But this gives you kind of a better way to do input and output if you don't want to mess up the look of the mod up here. All right, so let's talk about upgrading to tier 2. You need to get rid of these white capstones, the iron ones, and replace them with red blocks. And then you need to craft the orange blocks, which are blaze powder. So you're going to need to go to the nether and combine it with factory casings to get orange factory blocks. And then you surround them around the outside, put a few pillars, and then you add the gold capstones, or the tier 2 capstones. Glowstone dust, gold-plated skull. The skull takes iron-plated skulls. Here's where the crafting comes in. 4 iron makes 4 gold, so that's pretty cool. But yeah, we've got the gold-plated skulls now. So we finish all of that, and we should be able to whack this thing. Unprogrammed. All right, we need a tier 2. Let's go talk about what mobs are what tiers. I have them all. Everything in Feed the Beast Beyond that can spawn is in this chest. All of your passive mobs, your sheeps, your cows, your pigs, your chickens, wolves, mushrooms, horses, slimes, they're all tier 1. Easy peasy. All of the overworld mobs are also tier 1, so your creepers, skeletons, zombies, spiders, silverfish, and then some of your nether stuff, like the magma cube. You've got endermites are tier 1, shulkers from the ender tier 1. Villagers are also tier 1. And then you've got all modded items, unless they have specifically implemented something to be a higher tier, are going to be tier 1 as well. So blitzes, and we got lesser sprites from roots, imps from Natura, ancient golems from embers. I think in my Let's Play and other things I've said actually additions when I meant embers, but that's fine. But then you've tier 2 mobs are your ghast. This says zombie, but it's actually pigmen, blaze, and witches to get to tier 2. And then your tier 3 are endermen and guardians. Tier 4 are the wither boss and the dragon boss. All right, now where are wither skeletons? Why didn't I get one of those? I thought I did everything. Let's see, if we take one of those and we go to embers? No, roots. And I use one of those, I think. We're testing live, guys. And I'll need one of those. So let's go down. I have like a space where I was testing stuff down here. Oops. What went there? That guy. Okay. Alright, so down in here where it's a little bit darker. Put down a skeleton. Oh, we're in peaceful. Hold on. Skeleton. Turn him to wither skeleton. Punch him. Alright, so now we got wither skeletons here. And they are tier 3. Okay, so if you want a wither skeleton, they're part of tier 3s with your guardians and your endermen. Alright, so basically now that you have a 2-2 farm, you can choose from any tier 1 mob or your tier 2 mobs. So let's go ahead and get a witch. Sounds good. And we'll go ahead and throw that into the mob controller. And now it's a witch. Now, one thing about this is, what if you have a bunch of tier 2 or tier 1 that you want to spawn, you know, and you don't want to build separate altars for every single one? Well, this mob controller will remember I'm going to need a pickaxe here real quick. It'll remember what was part of that thing. Why aren't you sorting? Give me diamantine. Sure, I don't care. Alright, so now that we're in survival, I can break this, and you can see it will remember that it is a witch. So then I could just, like, store this in either in a chest or just hanging out here, and then I could grab another mob controller, put that on there, and program that to be something else. So, that's pretty cool. Get this witch one back. Where are you, witch? We'll put that on there. Nope, that's wrong. Okay. Right click, spawning witch, 240 RF a tick. I've got creative power, so I don't really care. You might care, though. Oh, come on. Are we not in creative mode again? There we go. All right, and this one should be spawning witches. Are you working? Progress 0%. Oh, I know why. Because I put a lever on this output. But you can see the tier 2 factory block holds, I don't know, like 10 million RF or something crazy. So let's wait till this one gets to 100% and it will, should produce some output, maybe. This progress 100%, what? There it goes. Okay, we got a glowstone and glass bottle. Now if we shift click here, we can see there's different percentages. So witches are gonna give us about a quarter, every fourth witch give us redstone, gunpowder, sugar, a little more on the sticks, a little less on the glowstone. They kind of go up and down. They're kind of random. I don't know. But you can see all the witch stuff we get from a witch. Typically what you would get for killing a witch anyway. Even modded items. Like that. The witch's hat. Cool. All right. Let's just quickly talk about tier 3 and tier 4. Tier 3 needs the green blocks. The green ones are ender pearls and factory casings. It also needs the diamond capstones. Or the tier 3 capstones. Which are diamond encrusted skulls, which take 5 gold plated skulls in a diamond. All right, so that'll get you your capstones for that. And tier 3, again, we've got access to all these cool things here, like wither skeletons, guardians, and endermen. However, I want to check out villagers just to see what they drop. I don't know. What would they drop? Villagers drop nothing. Like, it's literally nothing. That's funny. Maybe it's just because we're not giving it power. Huh. That is hilarious. So some mobs don't work in Woot because, well, I mean, a villager normally doesn't drop anything, right? So killing one would do nothing. Come on, go to 1% again. Yeah, nothing at all. All right, so that's worthless. Here, let's load this back fresh. Okay, so I don't really need to show any tier 3 mob. Now, tier 4 is the cool thing. Now, do you get that? You need the white blocks, and those take nether star shards, which comes from nether stars to get 9 of them. So you're going to have to kill the wither a few times to get all these white blocks. You're gonna need the tier 4 capstones, which are emerald, and those take an emerald encrusted skull, which takes 5 diamond encrusted, which takes 5 gold. So yeah, kind of compounds there. And this is the ultimate tier 4 one. It will spawn anything, including, that's good. Oops, I think I left him in the chest. The wither and the ender dragon. Let's put the wither on there. It should multi-block. You're gonna see this one takes 1,120 RF a tick, but we're gonna kill a wither every 16 seconds, so that sounds hella worth it, right? Let's turn some power on. And here she goes. Oh yeah, come on, give us some wither drops. This is gonna drop 100% chance to get another star, 20% chance to get some sulfur. And 100%, and there we go. We got another star. So kill the nether, the wither boss a few times, and then you can have infinite nether stars as long as you're providing about 1,000 RF a tick, a little bit more. That is sweet. All right, so anything else? Do you notice this red actually shrunk? It used to be 2 high there. Now it's 1 high. I don't know, so I guess it's not exactly upgrade, you just have to watch when you build it. The last one will show to get the wither boss, you have to just punch him with a prism, but to get the dragon, you need to combine a prism with a dragon egg. You can't actually punch the dragon with it, you just have to get the dragon egg and craft it, and that's going to use up your dragon egg. Alright, and that will give you the ender dragon, so if we put that one there. That one's now 12,000 RF a tick to get an ender dragon block. But look at this. We have a 20% chance to get a dragon egg, 80% chance to get breath, 20% chance to get a heart, and a 20% chance to get a draconium dust. So that's pretty cool. Every 16 seconds, so that times it by 5, you'll be having a new dragon egg. I think it's worth it. Yeah. I think if I'm good, you know, what I want to get is probably like 4 or 5 of these. And just have them constantly running. All right, we got some dragon eggs. We got 2 dragon eggs in that amount of time. And I don't It gave us 60 Draconium Dust, so it's not a 20% chance to get one. It's a 20% chance to get a lot of Draconium Dust. I mean, that was 45 for each kill. And we're getting one Dragon Egg, two Dragon Breath. Yeah, it's a little insane. Or maybe it was 30 Draconium because it was two. Okay. Yeah, okay. We've got more, guys. We got a little bit more to cover. And that's everything here in the middle that we haven't covered yet. And those are upgrades. And they make these things work a little bit better. The upgrades that we have are rates, which means every 160 ticks, so it's halving the time, basically. Because remember, we used to be 320. With with a rate 1 upgrade, it's now 160. Put a rate 2 upgrade in addition to your rate 1. You have to combine both blocks. It's now down at 80 ticks. And rate 3, you're at 40 ticks. So every 2 seconds, you can kill an Ender Dragon. with a looting upgrade, it's as if you had a looting sword when you killed the mob. So you've got looting 1, looting 2, looting 3. Then you've got the decapitate, and that basically gives you a chance to get heads, assuming the mob that you're killing can drop heads. The Wither Skeleton specifically does not work with this, so you can't use this as a way to get Wither Skeleton heads to kill nether bosses. Bummer. That's alright, there's plenty of things else in the mod to help us get skulls for that. But yeah, if you need zombie skulls, creeper skulls, that kind of thing. Enderman skulls for Ender AO, yeah, awesome. All right, and then we have XP upgrades. Normally, you'll get no XP for killing these mobs. That's not fair, right? So use these XP upgrades to collect a little bit of XP. And you can see that each of these has an additional RF per tick, and that will add on how much it costs to kill the mob in RF. And that's going to stack, basically, because if you want the XP 3, you have to have the 3, the 2, and the 1. So add all this together, and you get like 480. The mass upgrade means instead of spawning one mob and killing it, you're spawning 4 mobs, or 6 mobs, or 8 mobs. Maybe it does 2 by default. That would make sense. But yeah, so that just spawns more at a time. So if you combine the mass with the rates, you're going to get 8 mobs every 2 seconds. That is insane. And then you've got the efficiency one, and that reduces the power cost by 15%, 25%, and 30%. The last thing for upgrades you have are blood magic. So you obviously have to have blood magic mod installed, which Beyond does. And you need to perform, let's see, there's a specific ritual in blood magic that you have to do to make this work. It's mentioned in this book. Let's see if we can scroll through for a while. And it should tell us the blood magic upgrade. We have to do the ritual of the infernal machine near it. Within 10 blocks, the factory controller and the master ritual stone need to be 10 blocks within. And the altar needs to be within 10 blocks of that master ritual stone as well. And what that's going to do is when we kill mobs, we're going to drop 20 life essence into your altar. Or if you just put a tank, it'd be as if you had 10 sacrifice runes on your altar and however much blood that would give you. So that is pretty cool. So you can get 40 blood every mob you kill if you have a blood magic 3 upgrade. Okay. That's pretty much it. As far as crafting these are not easy to craft. The rate ones need nether quartz, something material in here, the tier 1 upgrade, and in a book that it matches. So this is rate 1, it needs power books. And then the looting needs lapis lazuli and looting books, decapitate, ender pearls and sharpness, fish and luck of the sea for XP, ender pearls and fortune for the speed, the mass, I mean. And efficiency is redstone comparators and efficiency books. All right, so that's your tier 1 upgrades. Now tier 2, you need 2 books and prismarines. Remember, actually, Editions allows us to get prismarines from nether quartz, so that's not hard. You don't have to go find an ocean temple to do that. And then redstone blocks for your rates, lapis blocks, ender pearls. You can see it gets a little harder. Now your tier 3 upgrade takes 4 of the books, and they have to be, well, it looks like power one, power two, two power threes. And then you need end stone, so you have to go to the end before you can get the tier threes. All right, and there might be other ways to get end stone in this pack. So, what can you do with those upgrade blocks? Well, if we look at here, it's going to talk about the level. The tier one here can have two tier one upgrades. The tier two factory can have four tier two upgrades. The tier three can have four tier three. Same thing with tier four. It is the same allowances. So let's say we want to spawn mobs faster. So let's get a rate one upgrade. And let's get looting on there. All right. So we can just put that anywhere in this 5x5 area and it'll apply. So let's just put one there and one there. All right. And we couldn't put two rates. That wouldn't work. Why didn't that multi-block? Huh. So maybe you have to be closer. Okay. Call me a liar. You have to actually be closer to the factory block itself. We could probably actually put this one here. Here? No. Okay. It's the only two places it'll go. But now that we've got looting one and rate one, we're going to see our RF a tick has gone up significantly. But now our rates are going down to 160 ticks instead of 320, and we should be getting a lot more raw pork chopped because we have looting. Again, this would allow us to do tier twos. So let's get rate two. So we have to put rate one and rate two on there to get the rate two. And let's go with mass on this one. So mass one and mass two. So now again, we're spawning them faster and we're doing six mobs every 80 ticks. So we're gonna get a ton of witches killed now. Look at all that. All right, again, this one would allow us to tier three. We can do four of them this time. Actually, we could do four of them on this one, couldn't we? Yeah, but they could only be tier two. So let's put efficiency on there so we don't aren't charging as much power. Did that work? There we go. And then we'll do XP as well. Yeah, let's try out the XP. So now these witches, oh my gosh, witch hats are dropping like crazy. Now we're gonna get XP shards, and they're like kind of like the XP bottles, but you just right click them to gain experience. So, yay, I'm in creative, so you can't tell. But so that's how you get XP if you want it from these mob farms. And you can see we did four tier two. This one allow four tier three. Again, you need the tier one, the tier two, three. I don't really need to explain that. Same thing with the tier four. Now, if you're doing the dragon, oh my gosh, and you do, we definitely want mass. That'll spawn more dragons at once. Okay, so now we're spawning eight dragons every 320. Let's do rates. Rate three. Okay, so now we're doing eight dragons every 2 seconds. That's assuming enough power. Right now I'm not providing enough power. This thing takes, we're up to 324,000 RF a tick, and this creative thing cannot provide that. Or no, it's because I'm using one of these. I might be able to just do, put it right on it. Let's see if that works any better. There we go. Okay, so the creative can do that. But now it's, just watch these dragons. Look at 64. Nine more. It's killing eight. We're getting pretty good chance of eight of them. And you get so much draconium dust, they really need to turn that down. But holy crap, guys. Then let's, I guess we'll put looting on there. So where's looting? Looting one, looting two, looting three. Now, I don't know if this helps because you can't, like, if you kill the dragon with looting, it doesn't do anything, so I don't think this helps at all. But we're full. We're already full of dragons, yeah, so we don't really need anything. Maybe efficiency would be good on this one. I don't know where it is, but you get the hang of it. Guys, this is an amazing mod. That should be everything that you need to know about Woot. Just a recap, get your hammer, craft all your dies, craft a little layout block, start laying down a tier 1 altar, pick which mob you want to kill, get a mob prism, punch it, put it on the controller, and start providing it power, give it an output chest, and you're good to go. Have fun crafting, guys, because there's a lot of it. Don't burn out. Work up over time. Guys, if you like this episode, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel to see more tutorials, and to see my Let's Play of the Feed the Beast Beyond pack, which I have titled Funshine X Beyond the Funshine X Files. We're doing a cool themed playthrough. And I plan to do more mod reviews and tutorials. If you've got one from the Feed the Beast Beyond pack that I have not done yet and you would like to see done, please comment below. And I'll get to it as soon as I can. This has been FunshineX. Catch you guys later. Bye.